Metro Council consists of 26 seats corresponding to districts apportioned by a population throughout Jefferson County. We have been spending some time each month to meet the members that were elected to represent those districts in the Metro Council. This month, we do it again as we meet the 9th District Council member.
Hi, I'm Councilwoman Tina Ward-Pugh, representing District 9 on the Metro Council. There are lots of things to love about the 9th District, all the way from neighborhoods like Clifton Heights, over near Melwood and the river that are on the rebound, up and coming Irish Hill, to attractive, safe neighborhoods like Crescent Hill, Clifton with their efforts in preservation, Mockingbird Gardens, one of our newer subdivisions, Cherokee Gardens, Lexington Road, Seneca Gardens. The 9th District reaches all the way over to Seneca Gardens, which is a great small city, and we work very well together. And then the 9th District has just a few streets on the edge of the city of St. Matthews. But what I'd say is the heart of the 9th District really is Frankfort Avenue. It cuts across five different neighborhoods or small cities. It's a gathering place where people build community and come from not only just the 9th District, but all over the city and even across the river to enjoy its small shops, restaurants, Fat Friday on the final Friday of every month, free trolley hop. To institutions like the Water Company and St. Joseph and the School for the Blind, the Clifton Center, the new Melwood Arts and Entertainment Center, the Girl Scouts of Kentuckiana, their regional headquarters, all the way to some terrific places to eat that make Louisville really a special place and the 9th District very special. You know, the other thing about the 9th District that I'm equally as proud of is that we are a district that is focused on green. Our Green Triangle Initiative, which is how we focus on making decisions based on looking through a green lens, every decision, all the way from small projects to our biggest park systems. As a matter of fact, Cherokee Park and Seneca Park are located in the 9th District, and we're proud to be home to those excellent homestead parks. You know, another thing about the 9th District is we have long since and been supportive of our local library. The Crescent Hill Library, located right there on Frankfort Avenue, has served all of those surrounding neighborhoods. It's in a Carnegie building and has been tenderly nurtured with local artists from the community who come in and painted lovely murals and wonderfully inviting places for kids and parents to come and spend some good time. Lots of people started the Friends of the Crescent Hill Library, which later became the Friends of the Louisville Library. And so we love our library and we do everything to support it. We'd love for you to contact the 9th District if you have any questions or comments or ideas or initiatives. And that phone number is 574-1109. Or you can email me at tina.ward-pugh@louisvilleky.gov. We also have an e-news letter that goes out every Thursday, and if you'd love to be a part of that, when you send me an email, let me know and we'll sign you up for it. All things 9th District, 574-1109.
The presiding officer of the Metro Council is referred to as the Metro Council President. Some of the duties the president has are opening meeting of the council, recognizing member entitled to the floor or to speak and keeping their debates within the rules, and otherwise preserving order and decorum during meetings. The council president is elected annually by a majority vote of the entire council at the council's first meeting in January. Appointing committees and their chairs is another role the president serves. One of the committees is labor and economic development. Let's learn a little bit about what that committee does.
Hi, I'm Councilman David Tandy, and I'm the chair of the Labor and Economic Development Committee. The Labor and Economic Development Committee, as the title indicates, is a committee that is focused on the labor and the economic development issues of our community. Primarily, we focus on first the labor aspect of the committee. The work that we do here involves making sure that all of the collective bargaining agreements that have been negotiated between the mayor's office and those respective collecting bargaining units have been done appropriately and are to the satisfaction of all parties that are involved. When we're talking about collective bargaining units, we're talking about the various unions that are a part of metro government, such as AFSCME or the FOP or the firefighters or Teamsters or the carpenters. And so though with regard to those respective bargaining units, we make sure that both sides, the administration and the collective bargaining unit, have had an opportunity to air out both of their sides and allow for them to come to some sort of a mutual agreement as to their respective contracts moving forward for the city. In addition to that, the committee also takes a look at the workforce throughout Metro Louisville, making sure that we are in a strong position moving forward to be able to attract, retain, and grow jobs right here at home. As it relates to the economic development aspect of our committee, what we do there is we pass different resolutions or various ordinances that help us bring jobs to our community. It could come into the form of grants that we receive from the federal or the state governments that allow for us to go out and to do different programming that helps us train workforce or also put people to work. In addition to that, we also will pass resolutions or ordinances that deal with tax incentives that get passed by the state and on down to us here on the local level that allow for us to incentivize companies to come into our community and to create jobs. Be mindful that whenever we're passing a ordinance that has tax incentives in it, what is required in order for that company to receive those tax advantages is that they must be able to create jobs and demonstrate the creation of jobs in our community. One of the things that we try to look for is that whenever we're creating jobs in this community, we're doing so with the mindset that we're creating good paying, high wage jobs that'll have a ability to keep us competitive moving forward in the future. The committee is comprised of 6 members. Currently we have 2 Republicans and 4 Democrats. And we work on the committee every first and third Thursday of the month at 3:00. So that's a brief overview of what we do here on the Labor and Economic Development Committee. I'm again proud to be the chairman of this committee and look forward to continuing to serve you again in the future.
In an effort to making themselves more accessible to their constituents, the council representatives from districts 12, 13, 14, and 25 opened the Southwest Regional Metro office. Here's Nicole Van Hoff Chandler to tell us more about the new office.
Hi, I'm Nicole Chandler. I'm the office coordinator for the Southwest Regional Metro Council office. We're at 7219 Dixie Highway at the Southwest Government Center in room 104. The Southwest office is a partnership of Metro Council members David Yates, Rick Blackwell, Bob Henderson, and Vicki Welch, and they have offered this office as a way for their constituents to have a more convenient location to meet with them and receive Metro Council services right in their constituents' neighborhood. The office will be staffed Tuesday from noon until 7 so that there's some extended hours, and then Wednesday and Thursday from 9 until 5. You can receive the same services that you would receive by calling your council person's downtown office right here at the Southwest Government Center. A lot of times constituents will come in and they want to show me pictures, or they want to draw maps or draw pictures for me. And it's certainly a better way for them to communicate what's happening at their homes or at their businesses, and helps us better serve them when we're able to meet with them one-on-one at a convenient location for them. Our number here at the office is 937-6143. People can email me directly at nicole.candler@louisvilleky.gov.
Thanks for joining us on this edition of City Files. Be sure to join us each month as we open the files to bring you more information about the city's business and who makes the decisions when it comes to spending your taxes and creating ordinances that affect your life. I'm Ramey Brandstetter. See you next time on City Files.
TV, a public service of Louisville Metro Government.